Αντουλάκος, on my turn, thank Dr. Zouvoulis and the organizing committee for inviting me to talk about endona and ultrasound in the treatment of anal diseases. Here we see the anatomy of anus and of the anal sphincters. Here is the internal anal sphincter. It's a circumference around the anus, and this is the external anal sphincter. And this is the perianal, ischiorectal fat. And here is the rectum. Here are the sphincters. And here is the anal verge. I would like also to talk to show you the anatomy of the anal canal, ultrasound anatomy. Here is the internal anal sphincter. And here is the external anal sphincter, and here are the perineal muscles in the deep, in the mid, and the superficial position. But I also would like to make an attention on the internal anal sphincter, as seen in the anatomy and the cadaveric specimens and the ultrasound, that the internal external anal sphincter, which is the most important sphincter in the anus, is short in the anterior position female, and moreover there are obstetric damages to the anal sphincter there, and we should be very cautious. Here's the anatomy of the anal sphincter in the deep position. Here is the vagina, and in the superficial position we see that the external sphincter is only the superficial position. In the deep position there is no external sphincter there, and here's the puborectalis muscle. And here we see the sagittal image of anal sphincters. Here's the external anal sphincter in the posterior position. And here's the vagina. There is no external anal sphincter, and the internal anal sphincter is very short in this nulliparous woman. And it's just lower. And this is very important for surgeons. Here we see also we can examine the anal sphincter, the anal canal in female through the vagina. Here's the rectum in the vagina, and here's the rectum, and here's the anus through the vaginal examination. The indications of endanal ultrasound are fecal incontinence, where we can see the sphincter defects, perianal abscess and fistula mapping, and rectal and anal cancer staging. And here we see an obstetric anal sphincter defect with a small fistula in a young woman. Here's a fistula, and here we see that the sphincter is very small in the anterior position. Also the same, here's my finger inside the vagina, and here we see that the anal sphincter is very small in the external anal, in the anterior position, and because of a difficult delivery. But we see a woman with a, older woman with a fecal incontinence. She has a fecal incontinence, but the external anal sphincter is intact here, and this is because of a neurogenic defect, and there is no sphincter defect in that could be caused by delivery. And here we see some sphincter defects in a 56-year-old man who had multiple operations, and he had a recurrent fistula here, but also he has this sphincter defect, and the surgical operation should be very cautious because he can be left with a fecal incontinence. And here we see anal sphincter defects after Peter Lord operation on anal dilatation. It was a very common operation for anal fissures some years ago, and so already some surgeons are performing. And here we see people with fecal incontinence and sphincter defects after anal dilatation. And here we see anal sphincters after lateral sphincterotomy. Lateral sphincterotomy is a operation performed for anal fissure, and here we see that it's a correct anal lateral sphincterotomy because it's only partial. Here is the internal anal sphincter in the left position, but here internal anal sphincter lacks. There's no anal sphincter, and still the patient has complaints because his pain was not due to anal fissure. And here we see the indications of endoanal and the health of the endoanal ultrasound in the cryptoglandular fistula. We can locate easily the internal opening of the anal fistula, which is very important. The depth of internal opening, the propension of internal anal sphincter involved, because the most common operation for anal fistulas are lay open, and But if we destroy a big proportion of inner external anus sphincter, then we have fecal incontinence, the ramifications of perianal fistula and anatomy of perianal abscess, and the internal opening of underlying fistula, that because usually perianal abscesses in about 60 or 70% are caused by an underlying fistula. And here we see an yesterday's patient. This is a, This is a anal abscess which was drained in my clinic in office settings, and it was a lavage with hydroxyl peroxide. And here we see that the abscess has disappeared, and here's the hydrogen peroxide inside the abscess, and we see that he has been correctly drained. And here we see a high internal, a high fistula, which was found incidentally during an internal sphincterotomy. Here's the fistula. And here's a low anal fistula. Here we see the deep position of the external sphincter in the deep level. And here we see the internal opening. And here we see the external opening of the anal fistula. And here we see also we see an anal fistula here in the internal anterior position. Here's the anal, and here's the peroxide inside anal fistula. Most usually we should probe, we should examine the patient with a probe and the hydrogen peroxide injection into the fistula. And then we see here a high anterior fistula in a woman from the vaginal examination. Here's the fistula, here's the anterior position, here's the posterior position. And here's the fistula. It is a very dangerous fistula. If we use the common operation of laying open the fistula, then we have a very severe fecal incontinence in this woman. And here we have a patient with hidradenitis suppurativa or Bernier's disease. This is a disease of abscesses, perianal abscesses. This is a disease of the skin. And here we see that there is no internal opening. The abscesses are caused by Bernier's disease. And here we see a horseshoe anterior posterior fistula in the sagittal position. The same, a recurrent, a recurrent anal fistula in the deep position. Here it is. Here we see a low rectal cancer. Here's in deep position and the sagittal examination. And here we see a squamous anal cancer with invasion of external anal sphincter. Thank you for your attention.